Welcome to Monterey, California. My name is Toby Fernie. Today I'll be sharing an update on a request that I got from a previous video in which I mentioned the term debt-to-income ratio. I'll be talking about what a debt-to-income ratio means and why is it important to you if you're trying to get a loan. I'll be talking about the credit score minimums that there are for FHA and conventional loans, and I'll also be giving an update to how the changing real estate market that we are currently in may be adjusting those debt-to-income ratios and also credit score minimums. Yes, while I know that this may not be the most interesting topic in the world, it is going to be extremely important if you're looking to figure out how much of a mortgage you can qualify for. My recommendation, as always, is to get connected with a local trusted lender, as he or she can look at your specific finances and let you know what purchase price you would qualify for in a home. What you qualify for is not necessarily going to be what you're comfortable paying on a monthly basis. Chances are it's going to be higher than what you're currently paying in rent if you're a first-time home buyer. Debt-to-income ratio is calculated through your gross monthly income. That's going to be your income before taxes get taken out on a monthly basis. Debt-to-income ratio also takes into account things such as your student loans, car payments, child support, or any other payments that you have on a monthly basis. If you live in California, then you are well aware that the cost of living is very expensive. Many Californians are spending a large portion of their monthly income towards their housing costs. For this reason, the debt-to-income ratio in California is higher than in other states. There are three different types of loans, which I talked about in a previous video. For a conventional loan, the debt-to-income ratio is up to 49.5%. For an FHA loan, the debt-to-income ratio is up to 55%. And a VA loan has a bit of a different process, so it's going to be even higher than 55% for your debt-to-income ratio for a VA loan. If you are a veteran, I would recommend checking with your local lender, as he or she can tell you the debt-to-income ratio that you would qualify for, depending on your situation. So I'm going to give an example here for you. So let's say that your personal income or whoever that you are qualifying for the mortgage with, whether it's a partner or somebody else who's purchasing the home with you, if your monthly gross income is $10,000, then you would be able to incur up to $4,950 in debt on a monthly basis. You're going to want to subtract any debts that you already have on a monthly basis. So let's say that you pay $750 for your car payment and your student loans. You're going to subtract $750 from that $4,950 amount. That would mean that you can qualify up to $4,200 on a monthly basis to add to your monthly debt if you're getting a conventional loan. Knowing this figure will be important so you can share it with your realtor and then he or she can tell you what price range you would be looking in for a home. Different types of loans have different credit score restrictions. An FHA loan, for example, and remember an FHA loan is one that is backed by the Federal Housing Administration that is supposed to support moderate to low income buyers, in which you only have to put down 3.5% for your down payment. An FHA loan is going to have the lowest credit score minimum. You're looking at around a 580 credit score minimum for an FHA loan. A conventional loan needs to have a slightly higher credit score minimum. You're looking at around a 620 credit score minimum for a conventional loan. And remember, a conventional loan is one where you're going to need to put down typically 5 to 20% for your initial down payment. And lastly, a VA loan. A VA loan is a different scenario than those first two loans. The lender is not going to be the only one that is setting the requirements for the credit score minimums. You're going to be looking at around a 620 credit score minimum for a VA loan as well. If you are qualifying for a loan with someone else, a partner, for example, the lender is going to be forced to look at the lower of the two credit scores. So if you are looking to qualify for a loan with someone else, make sure that you do what you can to get your credit score up so you don't hold that person back from qualifying for a loan. In a changing real estate market, such as the one that we are currently in with COVID-19, credit score minimums, debt-to-income ratios, and down payment amounts could be changing depending on the lender, depending on the bank. Not all banks and not all lenders have changed their credit score, debt-to-income ratio, and down payment requirements. You're going to want to make sure that you check in with the lender, check in with the bank that you're trying to secure the loan for, see if their requirements have changed at all with all of the uncertainty that's going on right now with COVID-19. If you would like further explanation or any more information about debt-to-income ratio, credit score minimums, or down payment minimums, feel free to send me a message or email me at toby.fernie@gmail.com. Please subscribe and share with anyone who you think may find this information useful. Please stay tuned for more content in my next video. Best wishes and be well.